Hello. This is Proxmox. By default, it only has one network interface. I call it LAN. To use it as a router, you need at least two network interfaces. Therefore, I added a new network interface. I call it WAN. This is the default network interface. I use it as the router's LAN interface. Proxmox IP address. Gateway address, which is also the IP address of the internet service provider's router. I wrote down the information about the LAN interface. Because the name changes in different cases, it's easy to get confused. VMBR1. I added a new Linux bridge. This is the WAN interface, or also known as the external interface. Later, it connects to the internet service provider. I wrote down the information about the WAN interface. This information is very useful when creating a router on Proxmox. The service provider's router has certain limitations in functionality. OpenWRT is an open source operating system. It can be installed on a router or PC router. In this case, I'm using Proxmox as an OpenWRT. On Proxmox, I create an OpenWRT virtual machine and use it as an ISP router. Follow these steps. OpenWRT. To create a new Proxmox VM, run the command below in shell. Proxmox. Shell. With just this single command, you have a router on Proxmox. Paste. Enter. OpenWRT VM. Yes. Do not use default settings. Use advanced settings. I use advanced settings to specify the network interface as desired. I only care about setting the LAN and WAN interfaces. WAN bridge. This is the setting you need to pay attention to specify correctly. As before, I want to assign VMBR1 for WAN interface. Therefore, instead of using VMBR0, I use VMBR1 for the WAN bridge. LAN bridge. LAN bridge assigned to VMBR0. Assigned correctly for my purpose. I assign the interfaces like this because I didn't want to change the Proxmox network interface. Setting the OpenWRT router IP address. I use a different IP address than the ISP router. I will change it later. I don't want the two routers to conflict, so I set a different IP address. No start VM when completed. Yes. Start creating a new OpenWRT virtual machine. Download the image file and create the virtual machine. Completed creating the OpenWRT virtual machine. I did not use VLAN. Remove VLAN. No VLAN. Save changes. Console. Start now. Now I launch the OpenWRT router. OpenWRT. This is the router's LAN IP address. It's not on the same subnet as the current network, so I set the IP address for this computer. Setting an IP address on the same subnet as OpenWRT. Access the OpenWRT management page. Default no password. You are prompted to create a new password. I create a simple new password. 123. Network. Interface. LAN and WAN. Next, I set up bridge mode on the ISP router. The ISP router is used as an optical transceiver. And OpenWRT is used as an ISP router. Write down PO username and PO password. Switch from dial-up mode to mode bridge. Disable DHCP server. OpenWRT will assign IP addresses to devices in my house, such as computers, phones, or smart TVs. Set up a static IP address to connect to OpenWRT. Log into OpenWRT. Set up dialing on OpenWRT. Edit. Protocol. PO. Save. Save and apply. 1. Edit. PO username. PO password. Save. Save and apply. Public IP address. Dialing successful. Check internet connection. Now I change the OpenWRT LAN IP address to match the ISP router IP address. So I have replaced the ISP router with OpenWRT. Save. Save and apply. Apply unchecked. So I can connect to network devices using the old subnet. For example, Proxmox. Change the static IP address of this computer. Successfully connected to OpenWRT. Log in OpenWRT. Check DHCP server. Set up computer to use dynamic IP address. Status. OpenWRT has assigned an IP address to this computer. Set up DNS address assignment. DHCP server. DHCP options. Set up DNS address. Save. Save and apply. Check results. Thank you for watching. Good luck.